Felix Bohm is the production manager for IoT plant solutions and data streaming at the BMW Group. That means there are many, many cars that get manufactured efficiently because Felix leads people in building real-time event streaming systems. Systems that capture what we might fairly call data in motion, and that helps drive those plants. And honestly, it sounds like it's probably a very cool job. Now, Jay sat down with Felix over Zoom, but I think they were both actually sitting, to talk about what BMW is doing with Kafka and why they're moving to the cloud. If you like BMWs, you know this is a job for a very production-stable Kafka service. Welcome to the stage, Jay and Felix.
Hello, Felix. Thanks so much for joining us today. I wanted to start, maybe you could just tell us a little bit about some of the problems that your team is focused on at BMW. What's kind of the larger role for this type of software, and what are you guys working on?
So I'm working in the production logistics IT department. So basically, we're taking care of that all the plants, the manufacturing is running. And there's some larger changes going on from, let's say, a legacy application architecture to a modernized architecture with the use of microservices, with the use of cloud technology, but also the making use of streaming data. And this is where also Kafka comes into the game, since we want to really restructure the whole way we provide data to all the applications down to the shop floor and back up from our devices in the plant.
And what are some of the drivers that push you guys to make this shift? What are the problems that you're trying to solve for in introducing Kafka?
I think the most critical thing is deep coupling. We've seen that with our hundreds of applications just in production logistics at BMW and thousands of one-to-one interfaces, you're not flexible enough. You have the biggest dependencies you can imagine in release upgrades, in deployments you do. And with Kafka as a publish subscribe streaming technology, we can have that decoupling to make the application itself more independent from each other and to be more flexible and more reactive to changes. And the second driver is definitely the transparency. So at the moment, you don't have a huge transparency on which data is processed by who and who's the owner of the data and so on. And our streaming service with Kafka is giving us the possibility to really introduce that transparency. Where's the data coming from? Who's the owner of it? What's the content? And make it available to everybody in a sense of a marketplace. And a third driver certainly is the speed of innovation. So if you have that data at hand for everybody, you're way more flexible on creating software, creating applications that bring your business ahead. And these are, I would say, the three major reasons, with another one coming in that's a big target of our manufacturing IT is stability. So stability is really key in the manufacturing. A few seconds outage or a few minutes outage can cost you quite a lot of money when the plants are shut down and people have to go home. So basically, this is where we want to have also more stability in our daily operations running the IT systems.
That's fantastic. And what would be some examples of the types of applications in this domain?
One of the larger projects or programs we have going on is to introduce microservices that are more flexible, more dynamic. Doing that, we have to decouple the systems SAP side, so the whole logistic backend systems with this more flexible microservices that are taking care of this or that. In between, we've introduced Kafka as a technology to decouple those systems and distribute the data throughout this application ecosystem, this being one of the major drivers at the moment. So from the classical logistics and production system, a second one being the more innovative area of IoT, so where we started quite a few years ago to connect our machine, our plant data, our device data to the cloud, to the Microsoft Azure cloud with IoT capabilities. And now we've took that a step further by introducing an edge layer, an edge ecosystem, where we took out the data with connectors. And from there, we really connected to the streaming service, so with the Kafka technology, to distribute it to all the applications, to all the consumers, to everybody who's has a use of that machine data.
Maybe walk us through some of the larger application use cases that you guys would focus on.
One of our largest applications is really the how do I steer logistics. I mean, it's all about having the right stock in place, having the right stock physically in place, but also in your ERP systems, obviously. And there are some very critical processes where you have just in time, just in sequence delivery. So we really have to make sure that especially exactly that part that you need in that area is delivered the second you need it, and you need to build the car. And around this, we build a lot of critical applications. Just taking an example is this just-in-time, just-in-sequence delivery that need to be managed. Your stock needs to be updated in the right way, and it needs to make sure that all the parts are at this at the right place and time in all plants, in all, I would say, 15 BMW plants. And here we have introduced the Kafka to make sure to have that data right in time available to the SAP systems on the one side and to all these microservices that add up to a big application, to really make sure that we are not losing any data and in the end losing any parts. And since Kafka is playing a role here, it's critical as the other parts of the application. And this is where we really see this technology bringing us ahead.
And maybe you could describe you know, one or two examples of things that you really couldn't do before that you can do now with this new stack.
So take, for example, the whole IoT data. So the machinery data you gain from your machines, from your sensors and so on. In the past, it was very hard to even get to that data. And if you have it, to get it to the right place without interfering with each other, because this is very critical if you connect to these machines and so on. And you're usually not allowed to. And with data, with Kafka as a streaming technology, together with our Edge ecosystem, it gives us the possibility to pull that data out once with our connectors, post it on the streaming service, and let every consumer or every application or everybody who's interested in that data connect and get that data. And that being on the one side the production steering system, so that really keeps the production alive. And now with the whole machine learning, analytics, and so on, all the guys that deal with those areas. So they want to, on top of the production steering, they want to really have that analytical data from the machines to optimize it more and more. And these use cases side by side is really enabled by that technology that wouldn't have been properly possible in the past.
And how does that end up helping the business? Is this, making it possible for you guys to find problems faster, produce cars more reliably? Well, like how does this fit into the bigger picture of what the business is trying to achieve?
It's basically, in the first place, it's helping our IT, as I said, with reducing the complexity to ship more stable applications in a faster way. And that eventually also helps our business. So I think transparency for business is key. And the whole thing of decoupling faster IoT solutions is key for the IT department in order to reach the goals or to match the requirements that business brings us.
For a lot of people, they may not know a lot of the kind of key software applications that you guys would have. What are some of those applications that depend on, your services that you guys are trying to decouple? What are some of the key use cases that this is feeding into?
So one good example is take the vehicle order data. So the data or the data where all everything related to an order, to a customer order, is stored in. So being it the configuration, the specification of a car with the manufacturing parts and so on. And this data is, or this business object is key to a lot of applications from there, being it in logistics, being in production, how you plan your production in detail. And that is very, it's very tough to get sometimes to that data because it's very limited in terms of resources, and you would always have to build another new interface for your specific use case. And that is slowing us down a lot. And with putting that vehicle order data or that business object order into a topic onto Kafka, and then it's immediately provided to everybody who needs that vehicle order data in the one or the other way, can process it, can enrich it, and can put it back onto the Kafka with slightly different attributes and so on, and be making it available to the next guys. And this is one key success factor that we see, that it's not limited, it's away from one-to-one, and you gain speed.
And when you guys were selecting technologies, what were the factors that went into that decision? You kind of landed on Kafka and Confluent. You must have looked at different options. Maybe it happened kind of gradually over time. I'd love to hear how you went about that.
I would say it's a two-sided approach. I mean, it's on the one hand, it's bottom-up and evolutionary. So we had some really core tech guys or tech leaders in our IT department starting using Kafka as a open source technology. This is what the foundation was, I would say, to get in touch with the new technology and the tech leaders really bringing that into their applications. And then from a certain level on, it became crucial to take that and to take the knowledge you gained and the convincing of the people that this is the right technology and have it top down and in a more sense of revolutionary approach. So we've defined this target architecture 2030. And with that target architecture, we really want to put some cornerstones how future applications landscapes should look like. And here the integration layer with Kafka played a crucial role. So this was then to the bottom-up approach to get in touch and to get to know the technology. It was this top-down to say, okay, it's proven quite well, and now we want to be serious and bring it to the whole application landscape. So I would say it's a two-sided approach, and you need both sides to really get the acceptance in your IT departments, in the teams that you want to go that way.
And what were the kind of key capabilities that made you pick Kafka and Confluent, or did it just happen? Was it more just a matter of kind of organically blessing it since it was happening anyway?
So I think technology-wise, it's the Kafka technology is what we see so far and have seen in the past is quite superior in terms of streaming or processing streaming data. So that was for quite a long time. It was quite clear that we want to go that way. But as you know, BMW as a big manufacturing company, you need the stuff enterprise ready. The enterprise license came in with quite a good offering that matched our expectations how to professionalize the Kafka as a technology. And this is where we ended up really with Confluent, with the Confluent platform. And then the step we are now in is really to take it to the next level, to bring it to Confluent Cloud.
What types of things are you targeting for the cloud? What does that look like? You know, when do you prefer to get a managed data service and when do you prefer to kind of run it yourself? How do you guys think about that decision?
So for us, we've seen for cloud in general, I mean, we run our on-premise private cloud since a few years, more or less successful, and you're limited in terms of scalability, you're kind of limited in terms of stability, and it's, to be honest, it's not our core business. So we go that way that a lot of companies probably go at the moment to really move to the public cloud. And there we see, as you said, two different approaches. Either I get something completely managed if I have a good offering here, or I manage it myself. So with all the individual software we're building before the cloud and now in the cloud, you really need to manage and to run it yourself, because it's very individual how you put together the parts. But a thing like streaming, which we see as the central nervous system for our production logistics, and it's quite a business that is reliable on stability and scalability. We wanted to go with a partner who has experience for a lot of years and can bring above the technology, as I said, stability and scalability into the game, and also some additional services and failovers capabilities that we could reach, but we only could reach with a high effort on our side.
I'd love to hear a little bit about what's next for you guys. What you know, you're on this journey. It sounds like you actually have a fairly long-term plan in terms of where you want to get to. What are the kind of use cases you're onboarding or the things you're going after next that are important to you guys?
Yeah, there's quite a lot going on at the moment, especially around Kafka and streaming at BMW. So with our 2030 target architecture behind this whole strategy, we have a few cornerstones, which is cloud. So we really want to containerize the applications and bring it to the cloud as soon as possible. We have the edge technology to cover all the things that shouldn't be in the cloud and cannot be in the cloud and have to be handled near the production sites. And the third one is then really integration. So how do I integrate the whole ecosystem with each other? And here, as we call the streaming service with Kafka technology behind, is one of the third technology stacks that we're basing this on. And so from our team perspective, the next step would really be to go into the cloud, to go into Confluent Cloud, to make that our stable partner for our central nervous system. So bring this thing to even more than production logistics.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us, Felix. This has been fantastic. Really appreciate your taking the time.
Thank you. Had a lot of fun.